Hello friends, today we will start a new chapter called Limit. This is a very important chapter in calculus. So first we do the definition of the limit. Before going to the definition as per written in the book, we can take a function, say f of x equals to x square by x square. You can say this is very easy as the numerator equal to the denominator, the value of the function is 1. But I said no, this is not 1. Say x equals to 0. So f of 0 will be 0 by 0, and anything including 0 divided by 0 is undefined. So f of 0 is undefined, so we cannot say f of x equals to 1. If we plot the f of x, say this is x and this is f of x and this is 0. If this is 1, then this will be like this. There is a gap in x equals to 0. So if I take a concept of x getting closer to the 0, what is the value of x if fx, what is the value of fx is approaching? Here the concept of limit comes. A limit can be written as short form LIM. X, in this case, x approaches to 0. But not exactly 0. The f of x equals to 1. But not the value of fx equals to 1. Okay. So the definition can be write like f limit of x tends to, suppose a value of a, f x equals to l, it for each epsilon greater than 0, there exist a delta greater than 0 such that mod of fx minus l less than epsilon whenever x minus a less than delta. Here a equals to 0. So, a goes to 0 and x, there is a small difference delta, then f of x and l, f of x cannot be equal to l, there is a small difference, here this is caused by this, this a at x equals to 0, there is no value of fx, as it is fx is undefined at x equals to 0. But if we approaches to x equals to 0, the function of the value of the function of the limit is equals to 1. So this is a very important definition of limit, and this is end of this lecture. Thank you.